हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू इलेक्ट्रिक जंक्शन, ए वीडियो सीरीज फॉर इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग स्टूडेंट्स। फ्रेंड्स, इन टुडेज वीडियो वी विल लर्न हाउ टू फाइंड आउट एंड हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द कंडक्टर साइज फॉर वाइंडिंग ए मशीन इन SWG एंड MM स्केल। सो फ्रेंड्स, we will first find out the cross sectional area of the conductor. So friends, we will have to note down some values from the data sheet of the machine for which we want to calculate the conductor size. Okay, so friends, for calculating the SWG size or the cross sectional area of the conductor, you will need to note down the value of the rated input of the motor in kilowatt. Okay, so friends, if you have given the value of HP, then you will have to convert it into watts. Okay, so we will solve this problem with the help of a numerical problem. Okay, so friends, if you want to find out the size of the conductor for a 1x4 HP motor, okay, if we note the power of the motor is 1x4 HP, okay, and if we have given the motor is to operate on 110 volt, okay, we are taking some assumption. This value, you will get these values from the specification sheet. Okay, you will get these values from motors specification sheet. Okay, now we have noted that the motor is of 104 HP, 1x4 HP, and it operates on 110 volts, and if the motor is 56% efficient and the motor's power factor is 0.55, then we have to find out the size of the conductor. Okay, or the area of the conductor, we have to find it. Okay, our problem is we have to find the size of the conductor or the cross sectional area of the conductor which we will use to rewind the motor. Okay, or to wind that motor, we have to calculate the area. Okay, so friends, we know that the power of a machine is given by P is equal to V into I into cos theta, which is cos theta is power factor, and eta, which is efficiency of the motor. Okay, the power of any machine is given by that formula. We will use that formula and find out how much current our motor is taking from the supply. Okay, so only I is unknown to us. We know the power machine is taking is 1x4 HP. The voltage on which the machine will operate is 110 volts, and the power factor of the machine is 0.55, and machine is 56% efficient. So in this formula we will put all these values and we can easily find out the value of the current I. Okay, so I will just put the values. 1x4 HP means 0.25 HP, and if we will convert this into watts, then we will have to multiply the 0.25 HP value with 746 watts, because 1 HP is equal to 746 HP. Okay. Now it is equal to V is equal to 110 volts. We have given that, and I is unknown to us. Power factor is 0.55, and machine is 56% efficient. Okay. So if we will change the percentage into numeric, then we will have to multiply, divide this whole value of efficiency with 100. So we will get 0.56. Okay. Now we will solve this for I. We can write the whole equation for I. So it will become 0.25 into 746 divided by 110 into 0.55 into 0.56, and you can solve this whole equation, and you will get that the current value will be 5.6 amperes. Okay. Now 5.6 ampere is the whole current which the motor is taking from the supply. Okay. Now we know that how much current the motor is taking. Okay. Now we have to assume a certain value of current density. Okay. And you can get that, you can make that assumption very accurately with the help of design books on the single phase motors. And the design book suggests us that current density value should be in between 2.8 to 4.4 amperes per mm square. Okay. If you want to get better performance characteristics of the motor, then you have to select the current density value in between 2.8 to 4.4 amperes per mm square. Okay. So we will assume in this particular case that we will assume a value of current density of 3.5 amperes per mm square. Okay. This value I am selecting from the knowledge of, with the help of design books. Okay. If you want to get more details, then you can read it. There are several texts available. Okay. You can read all these things. They will suggest you, they will give you all the details what will happen if you take higher current densities, and what will be the disadvantages of higher current densities. Okay. So you can select a appropriate value. Okay. So I am taking current density value of 3.5 amperes per mm square. Okay. Mm square. This is our assumption. Okay. This value, we have to assume an appropriate value of current density. Okay. And these things come from experience. Okay. And if you want to get experience, you can read the books. They will suggest you the best value. Okay. And they will tell you what are the advantages and disadvantages of the different values of current density. Okay. So we will not go into details of these values. Now we know that we have find out that current is 5.6 amperes, and current density del we have selected 3.5 amperes per mm square. Now we know that current density is given by current divided by area. Okay, now we have the value of current and we also know the value of current density, then we can easily calculate the value of cross sectional area of the conductor. Okay, so tail is 3.5 and current is 5.6. Okay, we have to calculate the value of cross sectional area. Okay, 5.6 divided by 3.5 is equal to 1.57 amperes per mm square. Sorry. We have calculated, we have find out the value of cross sectional area as 1.57 mm square. It is the value of current. It is the value of conductor which we will have to use if we want to design the particular motor which I have written down. Okay, with the given specifications. Okay, so now we have to calculate. We want to find out what is the value of SWG size for this conductor 1.57 mm square. Okay, so friends, we can find out, you can use this SWG wire gauge. Okay, it has different holes, and in front of this hole it has written the value of SWG size of different slots is written in front of it. Okay, you have to just insert the wire and you can easily find out the cross sectional area and its SWG number. And friends, you can also go on our blog and you can download or see the different values of cross sectional areas of different SWG wire numbers. Okay, so friends, now I will tell you how you can use this SWG wire gauge for measuring the SWG size of a wire. Okay, first friend, take this copper wire, this wire, and scratch it with the help of a scissor so that the enamel coating of this get rupture. Okay, so that you can only get the appropriate value of its SWG number. Okay, so you have to insert this wire on different slots one by one. Start it to insert into this slots, and your wire should go without any difficulty into the slots. Okay, and now you see on slot number 30 it is not going appropriately, but on the slot number 29 it is going easily. Okay, this slot it is going easily, and you can see on the screen that on this slot the number is, on this slot it is also going, here it is not going. So this is its SWG size, and its SWG size is 29. Okay, this way friends, we can calculate the SWG size of any wire with the help of this wire gauge. Okay, so friends, we hope you like this video, and thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe us.